In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us take a moment to acknowledge our sins, so that we may prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and the Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your word made flesh and splendor of the Father, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy upon us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm on foundation of love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second book of Kings. In the 10th month of the 9th year of Zedekiah's reign, on the 10th day of the month, Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, and his whole army advanced against Jerusalem, encamped around it, and built a siege wall on every side. The siege of the city continued until the 11th year of Zedekiah. On the 9th day of the 4th month, when the famine had gripped the city, and the people had no more bread, the city walls were breached. Then the king and all the soldiers left the city by night through a gate between the two walls that was near the king's garden. Since the Chaldeans had the city surrounded, they went in the direction of Araba, but the Chaldean army pursued the king and overtook him in the desert near Jericho, abandoned by his whole army. The king was therefore arrested and brought to Riblah, to the king of Babylon, who pronounced sentence on him. He said that he had Zedekiah's son slain before his eyes. Then he blinded Zedekiah, bound him with fetters, and brought him to Babylon. On the 7th day of the 5th month, this was the 19th year of Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, Nebuzaradan, king of the bodyguards, came to Jerusalem as a representative of the king of Babylon. He burned the house of the Lord, the palace of the king, and all the houses of Jerusalem. Every large building was destroyed by fire. Then the Chaldean troops, who were with the captain of the guard, tore down the walls surrounding Jerusalem. Then Nebuzaradan, captain of the guard, led into exile the last of the people remaining in the city, and those who had deserted the king of Babylon, and the last of the artisans. But some of the country's poor, Nebuzaradan, captain of the guard, left behind as vine dressers and farmers. The word of the Lord. Please respond. Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you.
And let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you.
By the streams of Babylon we sat and wept when we remembered Zion. On the aspen of the land we hung our harps.
Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you.
Though there our captors asked us the lyrics of our songs, and our despoilers urged us to be joyous. Sing for us the songs of Zion. How could we sing a song of the Lord in a foreign land? If I forgot you, Jerusalem, my right hand be forgotten.
Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you.
May my tongue cleave to my palate if I remember you not, if I place not Jerusalem ahead of my joy.
Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you.
Then Jesus said to him, "See that you tell no one, but go show yourself to the priests and offer the gift that Moses prescribed. That will be proof for them." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
If we're in need, just ask the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters, with one heart, let us offer our prayers to the Lord. For Pope Francis, may God continue to give him strength and good health as he leads the Church, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our elected leaders, may the power of God inspire them in their work for a just and lasting peace in our world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are sick, may Christ, the divine physician, see their need and bring them strength and comfort, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this community, may the Lord purify and sanctify us through his word and sacrament. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people who departed, may the Lord welcome them into his eternal peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all the intentions we hold deeply in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, you know that you see our needs and will our good. Answer these prayers according to your holy will. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine, work of human hands, will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the cause of the Church.
Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that cleansed by his ashes, we may make offering of heart pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, and Eternal God. For although we have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift. Since our praise is nothing to your greatness, but profit for our salvation through Christ our Lord. And so in the company with the choirs of angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim. Holy,
holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord, Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and given thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of the mystery of faith. We proclaim
your death, O Lord, and profess his resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Charles, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and from my divine teaching, we dare to say, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and power and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, live not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
For those who are not able to receive Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament, we offer a prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament, and I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself fully to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and the precious blood of your Son, we ask for your mercy, O Lord, that we may celebrate with constant devotion and may be a sure pledge of redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Have a great day.